Would you be interested in finding out the way to heaven? Is it by being good or by doing good? Lots of people think so, but is that what God says in the Bible? Let's get one thing straight at the beginning. Good works are a good thing, and seeking to obey the Ten Commandments or any other part of the Word of God is a good thing. Everything we say in the rest of this talk is not meant to demean being good or doing good. However, there is a big difference between doing good as the way to earn eternal life and doing good as the way to show my thanks for having received God's gift of life. Most people have been convinced, often by their religious leaders, that the way to heaven is by doing good works or by being especially religious or by keeping the golden rule. I'm sure you've heard that. Maybe you believe it. But did you know that the Bible says nothing of the kind? In fact, it says just the opposite. Listen to this. For by grace you are saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. Ephesians 2:8-9. Again, we read in the Bible, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saves us. Titus 3:5. Let's look at three basic problems with the idea that our goodness can save us. First, who's good enough? No one can be good enough or do enough to satisfy a perfect God. Compared to God's righteousness, the Bible says we're all as an unclean thing and all our righteousnesses are as filthy rags. You may say, I'm not as bad as other people. I don't do what they do. That may be true, but what have you done? For the Bible says, whoever shall keep the whole law and yet offend in one point, he's guilty of all. James 2:10. One of the things said against Jesus by his enemies was that he seemed to spend so much time with people who were obvious sinners. One day they asked his disciples why he did that. When Jesus overheard this, he said an amazing thing. If you saw a doctor with sick people, what would you say? What is that doctor doing with those sick people? Doesn't he know they're sick? But that's just the point, said Jesus. Those who are well don't need a physician. It's the ones who are sick. Then he explained what he meant. I didn't come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. You can read that in the Bible in Mark 2, verses 16 and 17. So you see, it isn't a good idea to pretend you're good. You'll disqualify yourself from Jesus' help. And he's the very one we need. How important it is to give up our arguments in trying to justify ourselves and agree with God's assessment of our problem. We're guilty sinners, exactly the ones whom Jesus died to save. The second issue is this: does God owe you? Seeking to earn heaven also puts us in a very strange situation because it supposedly puts God into our debt. That's just what's written in the book of Romans. Now to him that works is the reward not reckoned of grace, but of debt. Romans 4:4. Will you tell God when you stand before him that he owes you a place in heaven? You surely don't mean that after all he's given you, every breath you breathe, every mouthful of food you've eaten, every moment you've lived, that because you took a little of what he gave you in the first place and gave it back to him, that now he owes you? No, the Bible makes it clear that salvation is a gift, unearned, undeserved, paid for by another. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God, undeserved and freely given, is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Romans 6:23. The third question we need to ask is this: why did Jesus die? If heaven is within the reach of all those who do their best, why would Jesus die for us? We don't have to guess what the answer might be. The Bible, God's Word, is full of statements that tell us why he died. Here are a few of them. For when we were yet without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. But God commends his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:6-8. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there's no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Acts 4:12. The best thing any of us can do is to discover God's answer to our problem. It's simply this: repent and believe the gospel, Mark 1:15. Agree with God about the problem, our personal sin. Then accept His answer by believing the good news. Christ died for you and will pay your debt in full if you accept His free gift of everlasting life. Why not trust Him now?